Knoxville, Murderville. My name is Wendell. I'm here today to speak up for those that have been led to slaughter. The Bible commands us to, as Christians, to come out and speak up for those that have been led to slaughter. It also commands us to love our neighbors as we love ourselves.
Wait, what?
So if you are not loving your neighbor today, you are letting your neighbor die. You are condemning your neighbor. You're condemning your own child that God has given you today. Stand up, be a man, do what God has told you to do, to protect your child and your wife. You're called to protect your child, and instead you have condemned your child to die today. For what? For convenience? Because you want the things that you want? You condemn your child to die because you want the money? You want a big fancy car? A house? Is that why you've come here today? Or is it because you're not man enough to take care of a child that God has given you? I'm going to ask you today to go in there and get her out. Because a man does not sit in his car. Rod, you're on camera. Go ahead.
You want to fucking die today?
Go ahead. I dare you. You're on camera. You're on camera. You just said to me.
I didn't
know. I didn't.
As I was saying, if you are in this parking lot today, you are not loving your neighbor. The opposite of love is hate. You are hating your neighbor today. Your child in your wife's womb, or your girlfriend's womb, he's your neighbor today. I want to start out by saying, we are not here because we are mad at anybody in this parking lot. We are not mad at you. We are not angry with you. We do not hate you. We're here because we care about you and we love you. As I said earlier, we're called to love our neighbors. That's why we're here today. You are our neighbor. As Christians, we consider you our neighbor. We consider the baby in your womb our neighbor today. We're here to offer help. We're all here to offer you another option today. There's other options. So you can go to a Hope Resource Center just down the road. And we'll give you a free pregnancy test, a free women's exam, a free ultrasound. If you don't want your child, we will adopt your child today. If you cannot afford to take care of your child, we have churches lined up at this moment that we're willing to walk beside you. When the child is 18. So I'm here. I have to share the bad news with you today before I can share the good news, Jesus Christ, with you today. See, the bad news is this. In Romans 3:23, it says, "For all have sinned and all have fallen short of the glory of God." In Romans 6:23, "For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life." In Christ Jesus, our Lord and our Savior. You may say today that you've never sinned. You see, the Bible talks about that. You have sinned. You see, if you've never lied, you've never stolen, if you've ever looked at a woman with lust or a man with lust, here's one that people say they've never done. Have you ever murdered someone? You see, the Bible says that if you hate someone, you've committed murder with them in your heart. And today, if you are here in this parking lot, you are here to murder a child, most likely. You are either here for a surgical abortion, or you are here for a pro-farm abortion that they're going to poison your baby today. Or you're here for birth control that is a form of an abortion. So I'd ask you today to think about this. Think about this, is it really going to fix your problem today if you come in here and you murder your child? Is it going to fix the problem? Do you think it's going to fix your problem? Yes, you may not have a child today after this. But it's not going to fix the problem that you're always going to be a mother or a father. You're always going to be a mother or a father. You're going to know on this day that you murder your child today. You're going to remember this day. You're going to remember today that I murdered my child. Why? Why did I murder my child? Because of what? Reasons. There's three reasons that we come to places like this. One, it's pride. Two, we need a new heart. Three, we come to places like this for convenience, because we don't want our child. Because if we have this child today, you may say that I can't have the things that I want. I can't have a fancier car. I can't have a fancier house. I can't have all the things that I want if I have a child. You see, that child is a gift from the Lord to you. You may say today, well, I have to murder my child because my wife is going to die with that pregnancy. I'm going to tell you to trust Christ. You see, God gives life and God takes life. There's no man that has the right to take another man's life. You see, if your wife dies with that pregnancy, then that may be her time to go home. You see, I had a young man today tell me, And I could die doing this. And I'm willing to die on this sidewalk today to speak up for those that are being led to slaughter. Because God has called me to do this today. He's called us to preach His gospel. That's what He's called us to do. That's why we're here today. Because we do care about the baby that is in your wife's womb or you. We do care. We're willing to help today. As I said, this is a gift from the Lord to you. You may say today, you have to kill your baby because it was a rape or an incest. I want you to know that it's a terrible thing that you was raped or an incest. But I have a question today. Should we kill the baby for the father's sins? No, we should not. We should kill the father, not the baby. You see today, you may say that I'm not here to murder a child. I'm just here for birth control, a women's exam, or an ultrasound. Let me ask you a question. Would you be here today if a doctor was involved in raping 15-year-old little girls? Would you still be in this parking lot today? No, you wouldn't. You wouldn't be here. So why are you here today where they murder children when you can go somewhere else where it's free, down the road, or to another place where they don't murder children? Do you know what they're going to do to your baby in the back room today? Let me explain step by step what they're going to do to your baby today. First of all, they're going to take your wife and they're going to violate her today. Then they're going to take your precious baby that's made in the image of God. They're going to take that baby and they're going to take a forceps and they're going to crush its skull. And they're going to pull each arm and leg off, limb by limb. And then they're going to take a vacuum cleaner to and suck your baby out piece by piece. And then they're going to take your baby today and they're going to take and put it on a table like a jigsaw puzzle to make sure they got every piece of your baby. And they're going to sell your baby for profit. You see, if you're here for a pill form of abortion today, you're going to take that first pill this morning. And then you're going to go home, and you're going to take the second pill. Then what's going to happen is you're going to flush that baby down the toilet. And then you're going to be drinking baby cells that is going to be in your water. So I would beg you today to not go through and murder your child. Come and have a conversation with me. Come and let us help you. We have information on this sidewalk today that can help you today. You can take me to a Hope Resource Center, as I said. This child is a gift from God to you today. You may say today you have to murder your child because you had sex outside of marriage. I want you to know that that is a sin. But you see, your child is a gift from the Lord still to you, even in your sin. Should we kill the baby for your sin? For having sex outside of marriage? No. You see what the Bible says we should do? The Bible says that you should die. The Bible says that God hates the hands you shed innocent blood, but there is hope and forgiveness in Christ. At this moment, you can have that hope and forgiveness in Christ. Today, how do we value our own lives? I've seen many mothers go in this morning with masks. How can you say that your life is more important than your baby's life? Sir, do you know they kill more black babies in places like this? This is a racist place. Let me ask you a question today, sir. in Black Lives Matter, what about the black baby that I watched your wife go in pregnant with today? How can you say that one life matters but not another? I'm begging you today to have mercy on that child. I'm pleading with you today to not murder it. Your wife is not pregnant by accident today. You see, many men and women have sex their entire lives. Sir, please go back and get her. Please have mercy on the child today. I'm begging you. I'm pleading with you to have mercy on it. As I was saying, many men and women have sex every day of their lives, and they cannot become pregnant. Why is that? Here's the question. Why is that? You see, the reason that your wife is pregnant today, not because you had sex. Yes, God is a God of means to use sex for women to become pregnant. But you see, your wife is only pregnant today because God touched her womb and opened her womb to have a child today. Your wife cannot be pregnant without the touch of God. You see, God has had mercy on you. You didn't ask, how has he had mercy on me today? You see, God has had mercy on you today because he's given you a second chance today to repent and believe the gospel. You see, he sent us out here on this sidewalk today to offer you the help that you need today. That he's given you today, he will offer you help. That is the second chance that God has given you. You see, everything that you have today was given to you by God. Even your very breath that you take this morning is given to you by God. Without God's hand, you cannot take that breath. You see, God has given you the car that you have this morning. He's given you the house that you live in. He's given you everything that you have. There's not one thing that you don't have. That you have, that God has not already given you. Because if God took his hand of grace away, you would stop breathing at a moment. You would stop breathing. But please, I am pleading with you this morning to go get your children, to go get your wives, and to be men. Do what God has called you to do as men. I see many men in this parking lot this morning. At least these three men this morning in this parking lot. You're called to stand up and you're called to protect your wives and your child. Not murder them. You're called to protect them. I don't know if you have other children this morning, but if you do, let me ask you, if someone broke into your house tonight, you would protect your other children with your life, wouldn't you? At least somebody in their right mind would. So then why wouldn't you do that for the child today that is in there being murdered? Why wouldn't you protect that child? Why wouldn't you protect it? So please, I'm begging you to stand up and do what God has called you as men to do, to protect women and children, and to provide for them the way God has called you to do. You may say today, as I said earlier, you may say that your wife's here for a birth control. I want you to know that a birth control is a form of abortion this morning. It is. Do the research. need birth control. If you are having sex outside of marriage, you really need birth control. If you're doing what God has called you to do. Ma'am, this place kills more black babies than any place in the world. Places like this, ma'am, does Black Lives Matter? If Black Lives Matter, what about the blind baby that is in your room this morning? It's a child, it's an image bearer of God. Please don't murder it. Please have mercy on it today. Let us adopt your child. We will adopt, we will help you, we will take you to a hope resource center, ma'am. Have mercy on it. Please, I'm begging you not to go through with this. You see, the Bible says that God hates the hands that shed innocent blood, but there is hope and forgiveness in Christ, ma'am, at this moment. Please repent and believe the gospel of Jesus Christ. Would you come and let us pray with you? Would you come and talk with me? Let us take you to a hope resource center, as I said, where you get a free ultrasound, a free pregnancy test, a free women's exam. All free. Ma'am, we're willing to adopt. Please don't go in here. Please have mercy on that child. As I was saying, if you are trusting Christ, you would not need birth control. You see? You wouldn't need birth control if you are doing what God has told you to do. Women. You see, God gives a woman the ability to have a child. You see, I'm not able to have a child, but the woman is. In America, we say that children are not a blessing from the Lord, they're a curse. We'd rather have animals for pets. We say that there are kids this morning than a child. It's more popular to have a dog. It is a child. Why is that? If I walked down the street this morning and murdered someone, they put me in prison for murder. But today, we let so many mothers and fathers scot-free today and murder their children. Why is that? I'm hypocritical. I'm begging you today to not go through with this. You really think that these people care about you in this parking lot? Because they don't. All they care about is the money that they're going to get today. The paycheck that you're going to give them. But this girl does not care about you. She doesn't care about the child. She cares about her money that she's going to make today. Because her God is not the God of the Bible, her God is the money that she's going to get today. Man, what do you tell your kids? I don't know if you have kids. What do you tell your grandkids? I'm sure you have grandkids or kids. What do you tell them? Do you tell them you come and you murder, help murder children? Do you leave people to kill their children? Man, I'm asking you to repent and walk from this job. There's other jobs. You don't have to come here and be included in murder. You being on this parking lot today, ma'am, when you die, you're going to stand before God as a murderer unless you repent and believe the gospel. Every person on this parking lot today, unless they repent and believe the gospel, they're going to stand before God as murderers. At this moment, in God's eyes, they're murderers today. See, 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ did something for me and you. Jesus Christ sent his son to live a perfect life that me and you cannot live. He sent his son to die on that cross. He was beaten, he was whipped, he was spit on. He died on that cross and he rose 3 days later. He rose 3 days later, now he's sitting at the right hand of the Father, interceding for me and you today. We live in a time where everybody thinks they're a Christian because they go to church, or they pray a prayer, they walk an aisle. But all you know, that does not make you a Christian. You can't come. I've been this so many times. But I'm wrong and burning my baby today, and I'll ask God for forgiveness tomorrow or tonight when I go to bed. I've heard that so many times. But I want you to know, it doesn't work that way. You can't murder your baby and then ask God for forgiveness in that attitude. You have to have a repentant heart. You have to turn away. Repentance is like this. You see, the Bible says that God takes a heart of stone and gives us a heart of flesh. He'll take our heart of stone and give us a heart of flesh. We no longer want to lie. We no longer want to steal. We no longer want to come to a place where they murder babies. And I'm not telling you this because I'm any better than you today. Because I'm not. The only righteousness I have today is Christ. What Christ did for me. That's the only righteousness I have today. You see, you can have same hope and forgiveness today. I would ask you to repent and believe the gospel. Because the Bible commands you today to repent and believe the gospel. You see, we're all going to stand before God one day. What are you going to say to God when you stand before Him? Ma'am, let us help you. Please let us adopt your child. Let us, if you're not here for a murder of your child, then let us take you to a hope resource center where it's free, where you can get a free pregnancy test, a free women's exam, a free ultrasound. It's all free. Man, this is a place where they murder babies. Please have mercy on it, your child, today. As I said earlier, God has had mercy on you today, so please have mercy on it. Let us help you. Come and talk with us. Let us pray with you before you go in there. And we're not here because we're angry with you or anybody in this parking lot. We're not mad, we're not angry. We're here because we care. But if you care, we see you. So please, have mercy on that child. I'm begging you not to go through with this. Have mercy on it. I'm pleading with you this morning to think about that of your child that God has given you. Who's willing to take care of you, man, when you get older? When you can't take care of yourself? Who's going to take care of you? It's not going to be your child this morning. It could be, but it's not going to be because you're going to murder it this morning. Man, you're going to remember on this day, today, you murdered your child. You see, one of these days, you're going to drive by a park or by a school. And you're going to see all the little kids out in the park playing. And you're going to think about that. You're going to be like, I killed my child playing in that park. But instead, I murdered it because I wanted the things of the world this morning. Because I murdered it to have a fancier car, to have a job. And do you realize 60% of women that come to places like this, that have abortions, they have suicidal thoughts and depression? And what does that often lead to? Suicidal thoughts and depression lead to drug abuse, alcohol abuse. So ma'am, please, have mercy on your child. Don't come here to a place of death. I'm begging you this morning to have mercy on it. I'm pleading with you to repent from this wicked act. To repent from it. To repent and believe the gospel of Jesus Christ. As I said, Jesus Christ 2,000 years ago sent his son to live a perfect life that means you cannot live. Never sinning word, deed, or thought. He died on a cross. He was whipped. He was spit on. He was beaten. He died on that cross and he rose 3 days later. Now he sits at the right hand of the Father interceding for me and you. So please, I'm begging you this morning to repent and believe the gospel. And the evidence this morning that you that you do believe the gospel is this. And they said, that God will take your heart of stone, he will give you a heart of flesh this morning. He will give you a heart of flesh, and you no longer want to come to a place like this. You no longer want to lie, you no longer want to steal, you no longer want to covet after somebody else's things. God's saying to be perfect. You see, you won't be perfect. You, even as a Christian, you will still sin, you will still fail. But you see, you will daily repent. You will be daily repenting. You will be repenting over and over. That is the evidence this morning that you are a Christian. It's not that you go to church, but you go to church, you pray a prayer, you walk. You see, we do those things because we are Christians. I would beg you this morning to repent and believe the gospel, because one day we're all going to stand before God and we're all going to have to answer for every lie that we've ever told, for everything that we've ever stolen, for everyone that we've ever hated. You see, as I said earlier, hatred is murder. Hatred is murder. Today is another day to repent and believe the gospel. You hear it every time we come here. I see you every day I come. I'm asking you to repent and believe the gospel before it's too late, man. It's not work here.
Never quit your preaching, do you?
Repent and believe the gospel, sir.
No.
Because you will either repent now, or when you die, you will bow your knee to Jesus now, or you will bow your knee to him when you die. This is Jesus' kingdom. This is not yours. So please, brothers and fathers, we care.
Do you have a permit to use that intercom?
I don't need a permit, ma'am.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure, ma'am. Repent and believe the gospel, please. I don't know why you're in the parking lot. Or murder, where they murder babies. But I would ask you this morning to repent and believe the gospel. Ma'am, I don't know why you're here. Obviously, you're taking gloves in and a book. But do you understand that the Bible says that God hates the hand to shed innocent blood?
I'm willing to be judged by the Word of God. Okay, and he's not judging. He's saying what the Bible says, man. You're twisting the Scripture. No, I don't have to. I'm a retired cop. I don't care about your badge. You are not honoring your vow, your law, what you make. You're not upholding the Constitution. And then you suggested, that was a suggestive remark. Do you have a permit, ma'am? Show me where it says that in the Knoxville law. Hang on, just a minute. I didn't say that you can't ask me. What I told you is that you're a liar. You need to repent and believe the gospel, ma'am.
I would beg you guys this morning to think about what I've said this morning, to repent and believe the gospel. These people in here, as I said, do not care about you. Do not care about the babies that are in your womb. You see, they have to have a death squad today. Leave women in to kill their babies. They have to have an officer standing at the door, obviously, to help murder babies. When she's called to protect life, and she's not doing that. Actually, she's actually not called. She's called to be a mother. But instead, she's doing the opposite. She's not doing what God has called her to do. You see, women are not called to go work in the workplace.
If you want to do something, we were threatened this morning. Why don't you stand up and do that?
Women are called to have babies. You see, in America, we say that it's not normal for a woman to have a baby. You see, God has given a woman the gift to have a baby, the ability to have a baby. You see, I'm not able to have a baby, but a woman is. And so, the child is a gift from the Lord. I'm going to ask you this morning to have mercy on your child, brother. So think about that. Ma'am, that mask is not going to save you. You need the gospel of Jesus Christ. You need to repent and believe the gospel. You need to walk away from this place. Ma'am, that mask is not going to save you on the day of judgment. You're trusting a mask. You need to trust Christ. You need to trust Christ, ma'am. That's your only hope. Because one day you're going to stand before God. Ma'am, and you're going to answer for being in a parking lot where they murder babies. So please, I'm begging you. Ma'am, let us help you. We care about you and the baby that is in your womb.
Oh,
is it? Care does not care about you, man. Please, let us help you. We will take you to a hope resource center where you don't have to come here to a place that murder babies. If you're not here to murder your baby, you're here for another reason. Ma'am, as I said earlier, as I told the other guys who were in here, would you come to a place where they rape 15-year-olds? No, you wouldn't. Ma'am, have mercy on that child. Let us take you to a hope resource center where you can get a free pregnancy test, a free ultrasound, a free women's exam, whatever you need, ma'am. We will adopt your child. Please have mercy on it. Ma'am, we will walk beside you until that child is 18. We have churches lined up that are willing to do that this morning. Please just have mercy on it, not murder it. Ma'am, if you die on that table this morning, you're going to stand before God as a murderer. So please, I'm begging you to repent and live the gospel before it's too late. Because as I said, we all are going to stand before God and answer for every lie that we've ever told, anything we've ever stolen, for every baby that is murdered in this country. You do not know the time that you are going to die. You see, God is the only one that knows when you're going to die today. You don't know. You can die on that back table. You could die driving home today. You could get in a car accident. You don't know how you're going to die. So I would beg you this morning to repent and believe the gospel before it's too late. I'm going to give you the gospel one more time this morning. The gospel is simply this. Is that Jesus Christ, 2,000 years ago, sent his son to live a perfect life that me and you cannot live, never sinning word, deed, or thought, never stole anything, never hated his neighbor, never murdered anyone, because he was perfect, never sinning. He sent his son to live that perfect life that me and you cannot live. He hung on that cross, he was beaten, he was whipped on, he was spit on. Then he died. He rose 3 days later. Now he sits at the right hand of the Father, interceding for me and you this morning. As I said earlier, the evidence that you are saved this morning would be not that you prayed a prayer, not that you walked an aisle, not that you went to church. The evidence that you are saved this morning is that you will repent and believe the gospel. You see, God will bring your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. And you'll no longer want to lie, you'll no longer want to steal, you'll no longer want to come to a place where they murder babies. You'll repent and believe the gospel. That'll take your old nature and you'll give you a new nature. So please, I'm begging you. God commands you this morning to repent and believe the gospel. He commands you. It's a commandment he's given you. It's not a choice. Not an option. And I'm not telling you this because I'm any better than you this morning. The difference in me and you this morning today is, you see, when I sin, I repent. I don't live an unrepentant sin. And if you are here this morning You are called to repent and live the gospel. Christians do not come to places like this. Christians do not murder their babies. So please, I'm begging you this morning to have mercy. To have mercy on your child. To come and call up with us. We will be here for another hour this morning. We'll be here for a couple hours, as you said, this morning. So you have more option, opportunity to come and talk with us this morning. We can give you information. We'll pray with you. We'll give you whatever we have that we can help you. We will help you. We will not leave you by yourself. We're not just saying this. We're not just blowing smoke. We're serious about this. We are willing to help. I would not say it if I was not serious about it this morning. I would not be here if I was not serious about it this morning. So please, let us help you. I'm begging you. And I'm begging you to repent and believe the gospel again. To repent and turn to Christ. Because one day, you will bow your knee to King Jesus now or when you die. This is His kingdom. So please, repent and believe the gospel. Thank you, guys.